Hi everyone, it's Misty with Kids to Cradles Nursery and welcome back to my channel. And if you are new here, welcome. Today I thought I would do a video on purchasing your first reborn, also purchasing a custom reborn, which this baby was a custom reborn for me that I ordered from another artist. He is Levi by Bonnie Brown is his sculptor, and he was created by Alicia's Angels Reborn Nursery. I just wanted to talk about ordering a custom or ordering your first reborn and working with your artist. How to avoid a scam. I'll give you some tips, a few tips on that. And you know, if you're new to this community, you're new to reborns, and this is your first purchase, there are some things that you can do to avoid a lot of heartache later on by avoiding some of the scams that are out there. It's a real problem in our community. It causes a lot of issues for customers and for artists. Artists can also be scammed. We get scammers as well that try to scam us out of babies for free. So, I'm just going to give you some tricks and tips while I change this little guy out. I want to talk about him a little bit. So, I am an artist and I do my own work. But before I was an artist, I was a collector. I still am. And I love to collect other artists' work. So, this little baby here, this little Levi, and he's super, super sweet. He was a baby that I ordered as a custom. It was my first custom. I was really nervous about ordering a custom because I normally don't like ordering babies that I don't already know what they look like ahead of time. That made me really nervous. I like to usually go and look at photographs of babies that are already pre-made and available and choose what baby I want, like whatever just catches my eye with some reputable artists that I already know that are out there in the community. I will look at their photographs and I will see what's available and usually we'll pick a baby out or go looking on eBay for a specific baby, but shopping on eBay is a whole nother story and we'll get into that. So you got to be really careful on eBay. I sell on eBay, so I don't want to scare anybody, but there are some things that you have to look for on eBay as well. So I'm going to get into that. I did put some stuff here on my phone. This is going to be a little long conversation. Try not to be too long with it. But I am going to kind of look down at my phone so I can keep my place and I don't lose my place on what we're talking about, because this is a very long topic and I'm just going to try to quickly touch base. I don't want to make this a super long video, but this little man, this is the Levi sculpt, and his sculptor is Bonnie Brown, like I said. I've always loved this sculpt. He's a very popular sculpt, really well known. And this little baby, I think everybody just loves those little lips of his. And he has, I'm going to show you, his little arms are just, they curl, they hug, they can hold on to things. He's just so poseable and so sweet, and his little feet just kind of curl up. I'm gonna take off his socks here too. I think everybody loves, just for me, I worked with newborns for a very long time in labor and delivery, and for me, I just loved when babies were newborn because they were so curled up when they were born. That's how they usually look in utero, and he just curls into that perfect position. And when I worked in the nursery, most babies for the first 24 hours to 48 hours stayed kind of curled up like that. So that was just really interesting to me that she sculpted him that way, because that really is true to life. I mean, I never thought about the way you would curve their limbs to look more lifelike as a newborn. And I don't think anybody's thought of that before. And that's probably why this sculpt has been so amazing and done so well, because little newborns do curl up like that. And we can talk about painting the skin and making them look very modeled and having that newborn look, like that ruddiness to them. People think about that all the time, but I've never seen a sculptor who actually thought about the way this baby would just curl up into a little ball. I mean, that's how they would look inside their mama before they're born. So that was just amazing to me that she thought of that. Like, hey, babies are kind of curled up when they're born. So very sweet. I always wanted this little sculpt. He's very dear to me. I absolutely love him. And I always wanted a little blonde haired baby boy. So I had her root hair for him. That was my only request. She did have a baby listed on her page that already looked like this with these skin tones. So when I contacted her, I said, I'm really interested in having you do a Levi sculpt for me. I just love the way that you do them. I saw a few on your page. I picked out one that she had already done and said, I want you to make it look as close to this one as possible, only with blonde rooted hair. The one that I had seen, he had brown painted hair on her page. So I said, are you able to root his hair and his eyebrows blonde? She only asked me, you know, how I wanted the hair. Did I want it really, really scarce? Did I want it medium or very thick? And I just said medium. So that was our conversation. She told me she would send me an invoice. I paid way ahead of time. I paid up front. She was a well-known artist, very well-known in the community. I trusted her. I trusted her work. I went on her page, looked at the reviews, and the only thing that was so hard about ordering a custom is the wait. These artists, you know, they do customs and they do a lot of them. And you are on a waiting list sometimes for months. And this was around Christmas time. I ordered him in October and she was very busy at that time. I got him December 23rd. I ordered him the beginning of October, got him December 23rd. So it took a few months to get him, but you don't want to rush your artists. Art takes time. And if you want good art, you don't want to bother them. You don't want to hound them. You don't want to constantly message them. When's my baby going to be done? You don't want to rush art. So that is a tip. Do not rush your artist. If you're ordering a custom, you don't want to do that. So, I'm going to change this little one into an outfit here I have picked out for him. And I picked out a little bottle and a Levi and a Passy. I'm not sure what I'm going to use, so I just set out a couple of things there for him, and I'm going to undress him right now and get him going. But some tips if you are new to the community and you are ordering your very first reborn, you want to do your research and know what kits you're looking for. You want to go into Facebook. That's what I would advise. That's how I started out, was going into Facebook and just really going on some of those reborn community groups where people collect and people sell. And you're going to want to look and just see what other sculpts that you find out there. I loved looking at other collectors' photos and asking them, like, what sculpt is this? Who is it by? If you find some kits that you really like and that you are thinking about having reborned, I would know what the name of your kits are that you're interested in and the sculptors that create them. You want to know your kits, because if you go to purchase a baby, a reborn, and it is a scam site, I have noticed that these scam sites don't use the correct name. Like, they'll have a Levi on there by Bonnie Brown, and they won't even put the sculptor's name. They'll just call him, like, Sam Kit or, you know, Sam Sculpt or something like that. They will, and everybody knows this sculpt. There is no sculpt that is like this sculpt. And they will also say things like full body silicone, and there are sculpts, you know, reborn sculpts. Most of the sculpts are made to be, not all of them, but most of them are made to be vinyl sculpts, and they are not meant to be silicone. So there's a lot of times where I see these scam sites and they'll be like full body silicone, and I know that that kit does not come in silicone. So you need to know your kit. You need to know what kit you want and who sculpts it, so that you know that if somebody's calling it something completely different, and you're going to want to kind of go on eBay and look at prices too for that sculpt. Like, if I looked up a Levi sculpt and I go on eBay and I look up different artists on eBay that are doing them, if I see one that's like listed for like $2,000, I know that that is ridiculous. And that person probably a scammer and doesn't know what they're, you know, they don't know how much this costs. You want to think, you know, a really good sculpt. You want to get a feel for it. Like, look at the photos. If one is really crummy and they're asking $500 for it and it just looks awful, like, scary, you know that's a scam. You don't want to spend $500 on something that doesn't look like this. For a baby that looks beautiful like this, you're looking at least $500 because the blank kit alone costs hundreds of dollars. So for them to reborn it and especially to root hair, you know, you're looking at $500-$600 at least on that end. So, you know your sculpt, know, you know, the sculptor's names, and ask around in those Reborn communities for legit artists. You want to go into those Reborn communities and ask around, like, who made your baby? Who's a legit artist in this community? Usually there's a moderator on the page, and they will let you know, who are legit artists that you can trust and that aren't going to scam you. When you go on that Reborn artist page, there should be reviews on Facebook. This is why I like shopping on Facebook, because there is a review section from previous customers and they will post pictures of the work that they received, and you can look at how the babies actually turned out. And you can see the reviews from previous customers. And this is the thing about Facebook. You can click on that customer's review and you can message them and be like, hey, you know, how did you like working with this artist? You know, did you have any problems? You know, what were the pros? What were the cons? Did you really love your baby? That sort of thing. I was going to change his diaper and I was going to change it into this cute little diaper, but I'm noticing he has a cute little diaper on that I actually really like and will probably match his outfit really cute. So I'm just going to leave that diaper on, and also YouTube, they don't like, even though he's not anatomically correct, they don't like to see private parts. So I don't want to have any problems with my video. So, but like I was saying, you can go on these artist pages and you can see their reviews and things like that. So you want to get on there. You may want to talk to previous customers and, you know, just make sure that that's a reputable artist in the community that's really well known. Look at photos on their page of their previous work. You're going to want to see previous work, and you may find a baby that they previously did that you just fall in love with. And I have asked an artist, like, hey, can you try to duplicate this piece of work that you did? I really love this exact baby. And it won't be exact. It's really hard to duplicate your work, like, perfectly another time, because you're mixing paints each time that you paint, so you may not mix those colors exactly the same, and I always do my babies different. So you know, but they can get it very close. I do have a baby that I'm going to talk about in a future video, and her artist was able to do that and did an amazing job. I mean, I don't even know how she did it so closely to that one. It was so well duplicated. I really don't know how she did it. She amazed me. I was just blown away by it, and I wasn't expecting that. So, this is the thing. So when you do find a reputable artist, and when you are ready and you actually have the money to purchase, and this is the thing too, when you go to message your artist, please, the first question you're going to want to ask, if you have a little bit of money and you need a payment plan, first, right off the bat, the first question you're going to want to ask and establish with them before you waste any more of their time is, do you have a payment plan? Can you do a payment plan? And also, do you do customs? Not all artists do customs. I don't do customs. That's a story for another day. I don't enjoy it. So I like to do what I like to do and put my work up for sale, and people are welcome to purchase it if they like it, and if they don't, they can pass it up. That's okay. There's lots of room out there in the community for all of us. Lots of babies out there, lots of artists. So lots of buyers and collectors. So it's okay. We can all fit in the community together. So ask that question first, because you want to establish that first with them. Whether they do customs and whether they do payment arrangements. If you need a payment arrangement, make sure you find an artist that's willing to work with you on that. if you're paying cash up front, make sure that, and I'm going to put this little outfit on him here. It says, eat, play, sleep, repeat. And this is a little Carter's newborn outfit, and I think this will fit him really well. This little onesie was by Carter's as well. So it looks kind of nautical with little fish and stuff on it. So it's really cute. So like we were saying, if you do finally find an artist, you should already know what you want. The worst thing to do to an artist is to be wishy-washy, not know what you want, messaging them, taking up all their time away from, you know, their family, from their artwork, from painting, from listing babies, from communicating with people. And you should be ready to pay if it comes down to that. Don't message an artist and take up hours of their time asking questions about a baby and then be like, well, I'm just looking, I'm not ready to buy. You know, that's wrong to do that anywhere. Like if you go to a car dealership, you know, you should be up front with them right away. I'm not saying I haven't gone to a dealership just looking because I didn't know what kind of car I wanted to buy. But when somebody came up, a salesperson, I said, listen, I'm not ready to buy today. I just want to let you know that up front. But I'm looking and I just have some questions. You know, I don't know what car I want. So I'm just looking today and trying out some cars to see if this is what I want. And that's up to them if they want to continue with you. Same with your artist. It goes that way in the real world and it should go that way with your artist as well. So when you message them initially, please, please, please use correct grammar is a big thing. That sends up some red flags with us. We do look for red flags on dealing with people because let me tell you, there's a lot of crazies out there on Facebook. I get a lot of people messaging me about stuff that's not even about reborns and, you know, they first they'll act like they're going to buy one and then it's them telling me their life story and then sometimes they just don't make any sense and they're just, maybe they have mental health issues. I'm not sure, but I do seem to attract some of the crazies. I get about 100 messages a day, and a lot of them are not legit messages from people who are actually interested in reborns or purchasing a reborn or discussing reborns or whatever. So make sure you use correct grammar and language. They want to be able to understand what your question is so that we can help you. I do like to talk to my customers. I really do. I'm friends with a lot of my customers. I socialize and talk to them daily on Facebook. I like making new friends in the community. It's not just about the sale. It's not just about selling a reborn. I really enjoy making friends through this community and through this hobby. On Facebook, it makes it very enjoyable for me to be able to share pictures with other reborn moms and socialize and make friends with them online. I really do love it. It's a fun part of the hobby for me. But if, you know, you're calling or messaging, okay, that's another thing. Through Facebook Messenger, I don't know how, but somehow there is a way for you to be able to call people on there, like FaceTime them. Do not call your artist. Do not. They're with their families sometimes during the day. They're with their kids. They're with their husbands. They have lives. They're out grocery shopping, taking care of their family's needs and things like that. And they have lives. And please don't call at 1 o'clock in the morning or message them at 1 a.m. I can't tell you how many messages I get at 1 or 2 in the morning about babies. It's unreal. Don't do that. Those kinds of things just make me want to like delete and block people when they do things like that. It's just rude. It's just wrong. Your artist probably, if they're a full-time artist, they're probably working 15 hours a day, 12 to 15 hours a day on babies, and they're really busy, and time is money, and these babies cost a lot of money to make. Like I said, the unpainted kit and body alone can be hundreds of dollars. The hair can, for good mohair, can be $100. For eyes, you know, $75 to $100 for glass German eyes or more. So it costs hundreds of dollars to make these babies, plus, you know, the clothing and the box packing and the waiting material and your supplies and everything that it costs to make this baby, just to run your electricity and gas in your car to go deliver it and the shipping. And it's just insane how much money goes into these babies. So they don't make a lot of profit. You know, you're not in this hobby. You're in it because you enjoy it, not to make a huge profit. I mean, I know it seems like they're making hundreds of dollars, but you're really not. And for all the hours and time that you put in, you're really making less than minimum wage when you're making these babies. So if you are interested in going into this hobby as a new artist and exploring that adventure, it's not to make a profit, just so you know. You're not going to make millions of dollars off of it. I promise you that. It needs to just be something you really love, and it's just in your soul to paint and create, and it's an art, and it's something that you just love to do and you enjoy doing it, because otherwise you're not going to like it if you're in it for the money. So these babies are my heart and soul. I just pour my heart into them and my everything into creating them, and I'm in it just to hear how happy it's made somebody else, really. I love getting feedback from my customers and just hearing how in love they are with them and how therapeutic they've been for them. I love hearing that from my customers. So don't get into this. Don't get into this art if you're out to make money. And please don't waste an artist's time. They don't make a whole lot of money. So if you're talking to them for hours and hours and hours online a day, you know, about, you know, your custom or about a baby that you're interested in or a baby that you want, we call them time wasters, especially if they go nowhere. Like, we get, eventually, if you've been an artist long enough, you get red flags when you're talking to people, and those red flags tell you to, you know, you need to just stop talking to that person and let it go, because after 2 to 4 hours, like, that's ridiculous. But I have talked to people that long and learned my lesson. It's just a waste of your time. You're not profiting anything off of it. I have people that call me or contact me all the time, and they're like, I have money, I can pay in full. Your money doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to me. Like, I don't care if you keep saying you have all this money and you want to buy all these babies. And, you know, if I'm talking to you for hours a day, you're taking away time from my painting and from real people that actually want to purchase. And at that point, after 2 to 4 hours of time, it's not worth what little I'm going to profit from that sale. I know a lady who was like, I'm going to purchase this baby. It was only like $250. And she just like really didn't understand that I was only profiting about $50 off of the baby. And after 4 hours of my time, it wasn't worth it anymore. Like, I'm not out to make huge profits, but, you know, I could have spent that time talking to somebody who was really, really interested. I was going to comb his hair, but I decided he would look really cute in a hat. I've never put him in a little hat before, so I wanted to try that. And then this little pacifier just looks so cute for him. So I have a little bottle here for him, and that is so cute. It has like little, let's see if I can get this in the... little lions and elephants and monkeys. So cute. So I thought that would be cute for him. But I want to see how he looks with a lovey, because his little arms just curl so perfectly. I thought he would just look so cute with a lovey. So, I'm going to go back to that one topic, because that's huge for this video, is just please don't take advantage of your artist's kindness and time. They want to help you, but you need to really do your research first. And, you know, please, 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 this is another thing that's huge in this community that I've noticed. Please don't ask for cheap or free dolls. It's super offensive. Like I said, these people spend 40 hours of their time creating these dolls. Each baby takes about 40 plus hours, especially if you're rooting hair. That can take, gosh, I've spent 20 hours probably rooting a big head of hair. It's just rude. Nothing in this world's for free. You wouldn't go to Walmart and ask for anything for free. And it's just rude to ask for cheap dolls. Like I said, we don't make a profit, you know, really that much of a profit off of that. So to ask for a cheap doll, that's just not right. This was my other thing too. If you go on a Reborn artist page and you see that they have babies listed on there, I do my work and then I list my babies after they're completed, and I try to do some pretty professional photos. That's a new hobby for me, is photography. And isn't he just so sweet? Oh my gosh. He's just the sweetest baby. I list lots of photos of my babies on there, and I will probably put about 25 photos of a baby, and I have people that still ask me for more photos, and it's like, you know, I've taken all these like very professional looking photos, and I literally have captured every detail, every toe, every, you know, little earlobe, their mouth, their little footsies, everything. I go on there and photograph every single detail. And if you can't tell from the 25 photos that, you know, what you're looking for, and I make sure I get every angle, trust me. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to go set up my whole, like, photography studio and pull out the baby again and my camera and the batteries and plug everything in and my lights and whatever and take more photos for you. No, this is just not happening. I'm just not going to do it. So yeah, I mean, there's so much stuff I could talk about. And we're going to touch base too on photos. Okay. So I've had two people actually ask me if I doctor photos. In a way, I was really thrilled that my photos were so good that they looked doctored, but then I was really taken aback and kind of offended. I try not to get too offended too easily, but I was really taken aback because basically you're calling me a scammer. If I'm doctoring my photos and I'm not selling you legit, like, what the work looked like, that's calling me a scammer. Also, it kind of offended me as an artist because I'm like, what? Like, you're questioning whether my work is legit. Like, I can't paint things that look that good, like, that lifelike. So that kind of offended me as well. And, like, what scammer is going to say, no, you're right, I do doctor my photos? Nobody's going to admit to that. They're going to say, no, of course I don't use any special filters or doctor my photos. Of course they're going to say that. So at that point, I'm just ready to delete and move on. Like, that's just super offensive. Like, I would never go to my favorite recording artist, like, my favorite, you know, musician and be like, you know, do you have people doctor the sound on your records? Like, do you use technology and computer software? You know, like, is your music enhanced? I would never say that to somebody. Like, I can't imagine, like, going up to an artist and meeting them or talking to them or texting them and, like, saying that to them. Like, that's like saying, oh, you know, to a model, you're not really that pretty. I bet your photos are airbrushed. I mean, like, who does that? So, yeah, that's a way to kind of upset your artists and offend them, and they're not going to want to work with you. To me, I'm like, if you're that worried about it, then you shouldn't buy from me. If you think that I would do something like that, if you're thinking that my photos are doctored, then do not buy from me. And these red flags, your artists, a lot of artists, I mean, I know that people do need money. You do. Some people make a living off of this and they want the money, but it's not worth it in the end. If you think that somebody is so needy that you're going to have to deal with them for 40, 50, 60 hours on end, while they're waiting on their reborn, and you know you're going to have problems with them later if they're super needy and they're not satisfied when they get the reborn, they're going to just find some reason to continue to hassle you and cause problems for you and just take up your time, and that's not good either. So a lot of red flags for artists out there. These are some ways to, like, really tick your artist off and make them not want to work with you ever again. Another thing I've heard from custom artists, that I am friends with is, you know, they'll have people order a custom doll and then that person will, keep asking for updated photos. How's it going? You know, how's the work coming along? Is the baby almost done yet? When's it going to be ready? You don't want to rush your artist. You really don't. Like I said, you know, if you let your artist take their time, and I'm not talking years, like, don't let them get away with putting you on a waiting list for years or taking, you know, that's ridiculous. If somebody's taking longer than 3 or 4 months to get a baby to you, that's crazy. That artist is either overbooked and they shouldn't have overbooked that many people without telling them first, or they're scamming you. Something's wrong if they're not producing that work and getting it out to you in a timely fashion. I work on, and I know not everybody's the same, not every artist is the same. And like I said, you want them to be able to take their time. So, you know, the more time that they take, the nicer baby, the more detailed baby that you're going to get. I didn't realize this had little gloves, and I want to see what he looks like with his little gloves, all newborn and sweet, because I'm looking and seeing that he can scratch his little face. So I want to see how this looks. So this was a really long video. It's a lot to talk about, but I was just hoping that some of these tips will help you avoid scams, and some of these tips will help you when it comes to ordering your first reborn and working with your artist. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and please give it a thumbs up or like, you know, my YouTube channel, and subscribe if you want to see future videos. Thank you guys. Have a great day. Bye-bye.